Hello, I'm Kurt Owen, and this is my wife, Terry. Thank you so much for allowing us to come into your homes and or wherever you're at, on your phones or whatever. We've been talking about something extremely important because of everything that's going on in life. But, you know, even after COVID-19 is over, you still need to make a decision that you do not live an uncertain life.
Amen.
And there's a reason we're calling this series Living in Certain Times.
Yes.
Because you observed that so many were talking about Christians. We're not talking about the world Christians. We're talking about how we live in uncertain times.
Right. And it's so heartbreaking that you would think that your life is hanging in doubt before you. Because,
well, the Bible calls it a curse for that to be true.
Because that is the curse.
Right? Yeah.
And
yeah.
So what we're trying to do here is just to anchor you in the Word of God so that your soul can be still and not be tossed to and fro. And one of the scriptures that Pastor Kurt is combating is where people have this idea that you don't know what God's going to do.
Right.
And so,
not scriptures I'm combating, this concept.
This concept is being combated by scriptures. Thank
yes.
you.
Yeah.
And so we need to always find our answer in the written Word of God, because if you're just finding it in some meditation that you're doing about anything else,
right,
it's going to distract you and it's going to be a detriment to your life. And so we're trying to place this before your eyes so that you can have a prosperous soul and you can see what true reality is. And if you haven't seen Pastor Kurt's teaching on the reality of Jesus, please go over to the Kurt Owen Ministries YouTube page and find the message entitled The Reality of Jesus.
Okay. Amen.
It's important for us to start to look at this as we are believers. Amen.
You know, that's an important thing, is we're looking at this with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and we're looking at this because this story has been used to justify not having confidence before God.
Mm-hmm.
This is not just a story.
Right.
This happened.
Right.
This actually took place. This actually, there were three Hebrew governors, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. There was a king, Nebuchadnezzar. Mm-hmm. This is actually happened to people. These are people that actually face the reality of these circumstances,
mm-hmm.
and yet were not moved at all. They were, as John 16:33, that'll be one scripture we look at it, they were confident, certain, and undaunted. Jesus said, be of good cheer, I have overcome the world, right? Literally what he was saying, be confident, certain, and undaunted is what the Greek says. And so, again, this is the big if scripture. They've basically been told, if you do not, that he's created a fake god made out of gold, and said, when you hear the music, fall down and worship him. If not, you get thrown into the burning fiery furnace. They haven't been doing it. They get found out. They're ratted out by these other guys. And so he tells them, okay, listen, dude, guys, this is what we're going to do. If you fall down right now, great. If you don't, I'm throwing you into the burning fiery furnace.
So we're in Daniel chapter 3.
And we're going to be in verse 16. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered and said to the king, O Nebuchadnezzar, we have no need to answer you in this matter if that is the case. This if is referring to what the king has said, if you throw us into the burning fiery furnace. How do we know that? What do they say next? Our God whom we serve is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us from your hand, O king. There is no if in that. You can't attribute any if in that.
Mm-hmm.
So when you see the next verse, but if not, it's not talking about what they just said about the Lord. It's talking about what they said about the king. If you do not throw us into the burning fiery furnace, let it be known to you, O king, that we do not serve your gods, nor will we worship you the golden image which you have set up. And again, why would this even be a question if they're dead in a furnace?
Yeah, because the answer comes by the fact that they end up in the furnace,
right?
We won't do it.
Yeah, nobody's questioning that.
Right.
And so then they take a stand for the Lord. Now, again, it gets worse before it gets better. He says we're going to heat it up.
And when we say worse, we mean much worse.
Yes, seven times worse. Don't think that just because you took a stand for the Lord that all of a sudden it's going to be rainbows and unicorns.
Right.
It's not working that way. A lot of times you're going to have to fight your way through. You're going to have to be strong.
Right.
This is no different than Abraham, the day that God said, when God said to him, when he said to God, how shall I know that your word is going to be true? Well, kill these animals and I'm going to swear a blood covenant to you. It says that he fought all day, had to fight the buzzards off the sacrifice. Mm-hmm. It wasn't that God just showed up immediately. I don't know why that happens. I don't know why it is that we take a stand and then all of a sudden everything's just not fixed, that sometimes we have to fight it through. But what do we care? Right. Because we actually live in certain times. No right. matter what happens, even if it gets certain times worse, we know how this turns out. Right. And let's talk about how it turns out. So they have these men, the mighty men. First they bind them up, right? They get bound, right? And then they throw them into the furnace and they land on the fire. They're laying down initially, right? It says that they fall down into the burning fiery furnace. It says and they were cast into the burning fiery furnace. Therefore, the king's command was urgent and the furnace was exceedingly hot. The fire kills the mighty men, which took Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And again, you kind of brought this out yesterday, that would that affect you? That you were pretty bold until you see the people around you dying, right? Right?
And it's bound.
That you're bound. And these men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, fell down, bound into the burning fiery furnace. Okay, so now they've fallen down and they're bound. Now, then the king says, O Nebuchadnezzar was astonished. And he rose in haste and spoke, saying to his counselors, did we not cast three men into the midst of the fire? They're bound into the midst of the fire. They answered and said to him, true, O king. Look, he answered and says, I see four men loose. It makes a point right. of that the fact that they're loose, walking around in the midst of the fire, and they are not hurt. And the form of the fourth is like the Son of God. Okay. So they have been threatened by the king, and now they're encumbered, they're bound, and they get thrown into the furnace. Now, even in the midst of the trial, they're free.
Right.
The only thing that got destroyed, and we're going to see this really clear in just a minute, mm-hmm. the only thing that gets destroyed in the midst of the fiery trial
was
the things that bound them, any bondages. They are freer standing in the fire than they were standing outside with the king. Mm-hmm. And they're walking around and they're fellowshipping with this God that they knew that even if we end up here, we are still going to be free.
Right.
They're not, and by the way, they're not running for the door. Because what happens is this. Then Nebuchadnezzar went near to the mouth of the burning fire furnace and spoke to the saying, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, servants of the Most High God. Amazing how the crowd changes when you take a stand
right.
and you see the deliverance of God. Come out and come here. Then Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came from the midst of the fire. Go ahead. What were you going to say?
There's no indication the furnace got turned off.
Yeah. 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 There is no indication. He's yelling. Now notice this.
And then you're going to say, come out here. You're
right,
in
right.
a fiery furnace, which indicates there's a pit because they're walking
right,
around.
Right, right, right.
And he's looking down into it and he says, come up here. And
come out here.
There must have been something that Nebuchadnezzar put two and two together and said, well, if your God can deliver you in there and keep you alive, he can certainly get you up here onto our level.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. And now here's the thing. This king thought, so I have power over you. Who is the God? He is mocking them. And now he knows there is a God that is unlike any other God I have ever encountered. And now notice this. They're not trying to run. They're not trying to get delivered out of the fire. They're free right in the midst of the fire. We're doing fine. Mm-hmm. And so the king has to come to the door and say, hey, guys, hey, you got a minute? You think you could come outside? Could we talk a minute? Can you come out of the thing that I created to destroy you?
Right.
Could you? You are freer now than you have ever been.
And you're a living testimony.
And you're a living testimony. And now I'm asking you, would you mind coming outside?
Mm-hmm.
See, they weren't running in fear.
Right.
What's that, king? Oh, you want us to come outside? Okay, yeah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for delivering us. He wants to talk to us now.
Right. And it gets even more fun. really.
Yeah, it really does.
And then the satraps, the administrators and the governors and the king's counselors gathered together, and they saw these men on whose body the fire had no power.
Amen.
The hair of their head was not singed, nor were their garments affected, and the smell of fire was not on them.
Now, this, what I find interesting about this is a lot of different things. First off, the king says to them, you need to face reality. Mm-hmm. You need to face this reality. If you don't listen to me, you're going to die in the furnace. And now the king and all of these people have found out what reality truly is.
Absolutely.
That reality truly is him. Mm-hmm. But here's the other thing that's important. When you walked out, if you saw Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego later that day, right, you would have never known they were in a furnace.
That's right.
There wasn't the smell. Right. There wasn't the look. The only thing that happened to them in the furnace was freedom and a more intimate, closer relationship with the Lord.
And let's think about that. Let's not be super spiritual about
it. Yeah, yeah.
If you go to a barbecue,
right,
or you're even just grilling outside in the backyard,
right,
on your grill, and there's smoke coming out of the barbecue, any person you're around goes,
yeah,
hey, you been to a barbecue?
Yeah.
Because
yeah,
the smell is so strong. And so we need to understand that this is a big deal, and that's why it's in the Bible. Because God's telling us that our circumstances do not dictate our outcome.
That's absolutely right. And when you come out of this, if you don't bow, you don't burn.
Amen.
And when you come out of this,
I like that.
That was Oral Roberts came up with that. So when you walk out of these things, you are going to walk a life completely unaffected by the furnace,
yes,
completely unaffected by what happened to you yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
And you will be in a better position, because I guarantee you the king wasn't threatening them anymore.
That's
Thank
right.
you for taking the time. Remember, because Jesus is risen,
victory is assured.